Let's do it.
Saturday, April 2019, Watchtower Bible and Tract Society, Warwick, New York, 10990. Dear publishers, we accept the fact that we have you sacrificing whole Saturdays in service for whatever we tell you is wrong. Your former lives were wrong, but we think the apostates are crazy to make us tell you who we think we are. What do you care? You see us as we want you to see us. In the simplest terms and the most convenient definitions, you see us as
the faithful and discreet slave.
Innocent victims.
Friendly, so warm and kind, and balanced too.
Taking the lead.
Motivated with sincerity.
Moved by Holy Spirit.
Special full-time servants.
A wonderful gift from Jehovah.
Correct? That's the way we present ourselves around the world. You were brainwashed.
Nathan Knorr, under the influence of Vice President Fred Franz, was responsible for the 1975 false prophecy.
I remember how excited we all were as we studied this book, Life Everlasting in the Freedom of the Sons of God, and learned that 1975 would mark the end of the 6,000 years of man's history.
The way the Watchtower representatives, the circuit overseers, would come by and say, edging forward and whispering confidently into the microphone, only 37 months till Armageddon, brothers.
The Great Tribulation was coming. It was 1974, and 1975 was at our doorstep.
A few years before 1975, the elders convinced me to sell my stamp collection, which had been in my family for three generations. Had I kept it, it would be worth over $1 million today.
I remember how we were kept on the edge of our seats at our assemblies in the late 1960s, while a society paraded one couple after another onto the platform, who had sold their houses and goods and had gone full-time in the ministry for the few remaining months before Armageddon.
1975 was approaching, and then as 75 got closer, though some criticized me, even calling me the ridiculer of Second Peter, and I just told them, well, when the Watchtower stops growing, I'll stop growing. And of course, here we are today, many years later.
1975 came and went without Armageddon and without the ushering in of the thousand-year reign of Christ.
Dear Jehovah, we accept the fact that we had publishers sacrifice their entire lives for whatever we said was wrong, but we think you're crazy to want us to confess to you who we think we are. You see us as you want to see us. In the simplest terms, in the most convenient definitions. But what you found out is that each one of us are
the lesser one.
Disappointments.
Simply overwhelming.
Tight-fisted.
Irritating or demeaning.
Wicked people.
The evil slave.
Representing ourselves.
Does that answer your question? Sincerely yours, the Governing Body.